What's up everyone, and thanks for watching again today. Today I'm showing you something very unique. On my YouTube channel, over the past few years, we have seen amazing species of moths. We've seen the biggest species of the entire world, and we've seen it in all shapes and colors and sizes, from brown to pink to blue to gray to yellow, you can think of it. And there's probably a moth like that on my YouTube channel. But today I'm really showing something that's totally unique and bizarre, and that even my channel hasn't shown before. And that is a wingless moth. That's right. Here's a fun fact. Not all moth species have wings. And what we see here is a wingless female of the vapor moth, the Orchia antica. And basically this is a wingless moth. She has a massive abdomen and a few legs she can crawl with. Otherwise, she cannot do much but basically sit still and wait for a male to arrive. Now, the natural phenomenon where winged insects basically grow wingless and have reduced flight capabilities is called, with an expensive term, brachypterism. Now, brachypterism means that basically the insects for some reason have no need for their wings anymore. So it's like use it or lose it in nature. And because of evolution, they stop investing in functional wings. Which results in reduced wings like this. And the reason that the females of the Orchia antica, the vapor moth, are wingless, or brachypterus, is because, well, moths, they have sexual roles. It's usually the male's task to locate the female. The female just sits still, waiting for days for a male to arrive. And this is true even in some very big moth species, like atlas moth, comet moth, even big silk moths that have pretty big wings, may not even use them that often, especially when it's about the females. See, the problem is females have a very high biomass because they have the biological burden of having to carry all the eggs inside her body, and this makes her too heavy and very clumsy, and she basically, flying is very risky for her. So what she will do is she will try to remain still for as long as possible and wait for a male to come. Some species just take this one step further and decide not to move at all. It also happens that many caterpillars, when they spin a cocoon, they make a cocoon on their food plant. And when they hatch from the cocoon, they already hatched on the perfect place to lay their eggs. Because in some cases females may fly to find a good place to lay their eggs, like a food plant. If you already hatch from your food plant, then there's no use in flying. It's just an extra risk. So this species just takes these sexual roles a little bit further than other species and turns the female into a live egg-laying machine.